can't you see the conspiracy that's happening? I mean, for how much longer can you live the life you do? And when will the time come when actions will speak louder than words?
People talking all around me, all their words just seem to drown me. And the truth that was lurking in my mind I couldn't find. What the hell are we fighting for? Someone tell me how much more. Will you suffer before the sky falls on your head and makes it try? Trying for.
Being the mother of many, the tribe had to keep its harvest plans. The production of the expected goods was of primary importance, or so they said, and the years of discontent were upon us. This was their explanation, and a justification which made anyone who questioned this liable for treason. They soon had workers. They plucked the group's fleas from them, and scratched them when the irritation of their skin became too much. Of course they gave their workers ample opportunity to make good for themselves, but always loomed large in the background, screaming whispers of orders, or demolishing thoughts they believed to be too risky. We often discussed matters of importance over dinner, in a large room, pretending to be farmers. We frequently came to mutual understandings about facts and figures. I remember vividly one of these sessions. It was a Sunday, although every day seemed like a Sunday. Someone mentioned the word equality. They seemed taken aback at our loss of trust. The master at the head of the table stood up, his voice resonating around the large farmhouse, or so they thought, and assured us that whatever it came across as, everyone was just like the man sitting next to him. I was in the corner with a wall either side of me. I later discovered that we were equals, but the fact that we took orders, indirect or otherwise, did, I must say, puzzle me greatly. Soon, the leaders became mothers of influence and mothers of cultivation. But us children sowed the seeds again for a fine harvest. The seeds fed off our blood. We could not help but cope. Happy with the confinement the family put us in, our lives continued as normal, working each day. Still, the group catered for anyone who thought the family gave them everything they ever wanted. They kept the well-groomed masses well informed and under constant threat of being told to wear a uniform. I heard a traitor say that this was in a way unchallenging, but the general good word spoken by the rest of us was that the masters were doing a good job. Still, they provide us our food. Still, they satisfy our thirst. Then one day, when the chief did not answer our question and told us of greener pastures elsewhere, we decided to call it a lifetime. A person I hardly knew spoke the first words of wisdom. He said, "We came for nothing. but settled for less. These were the last words of wisdom.
The problem's clear.